Now, the last day for filing nominations for the Karnataka elections is over, and the voters now know the choices they have. And right up to the last minute, there were surprises.
On the very last day of the filing of nominations in Karnataka, Badami was the scene of shows of strength by heavyweight contenders from the Congress and the BJP. Congress Chief Minister Siddaramaiah is contesting from this North Karnataka seat as a second seat, filing his nomination on the very last day. And he knew who he would be up against only on the last day. BJP MP B. Sri Ramulu, the close aide of the mining millionaire Reddy brothers, flying in on his helicopter to take on the Chief Minister.
Our party is not a good thing. I am not worried about who is my opponent.
Only today, while we were watching the news, we came to know finally that Mr. Siddaramaiah from the Congress party, the incumbent chief minister, is going to contest from a second constituency of Badami as well. The list says that yesterday, that is 24th, 4th, 2018, Mr. Siddaramaiah was to visit the Badami constituency. And within few hours, that was cancelled. So in fact, Mr. Siddaramaiah was only trying to hide behind the alibi that the high command is wanting him to contest from a second constituency of Badami. The fact is, he was not confident within.
So while Badami looks like an interesting contest, another interesting face-off is no longer happening. Varuna will have the Chief Minister's son, Dr. Yathindra, but no Vijayendra, the son of Yediyurappa, to take him on after a last-minute change in plan. Vijayendra has instead been made General Secretary of the BJP Yuva Morcha. Apart from Sri Ramulu, another two men connected to the controversial Janardhana Reddy, his own two brothers, Karunakara and Somashekhara, have been given tickets by the BJP. This despite Amit Shah saying the party had no connection with Janardhan Reddy, who is accused of major scams connected to iron ore mining.
Modi government has actually come to the rescue of what all Karnadigas call the Bellari gang. No wonder that the then chief minister, Shri B.S. Yediyurappa, had to be sacked.
And while the father-son duo of Yediyurappa and Vijayendra did not work out, the Congress has quite a few fathers and offspring as candidates in this election. The Chief Minister, Home Minister and Law Minister each have a child in the fray. Film star Ambarish, given the Congress ticket for Mandya, finally decided not to contest, saying he was too old to campaign.
Old faces and new. The Karnataka voters have been presented with their choices for the elections to the State Assembly in May. And with so much drama in just the selection of candidates, it is clear that the elections themselves and the results will be an exciting prelude to the general elections in 2019. With DM Kumar, Maya Sharma in Bengaluru for NDTV.